Welcome back to our Halloween version of Room by Room. As you can see, I'm in the spirit of things by dressing in haunting Halloween hues. Because I don't want to stand out in the room, I want to blend, hide, and perhaps scare you a bit. So let's take a look. Once warm and inviting, the flicker of the candle's flame, now in the heavy darkness, can't lighten the quivering shadows it creates. And beware of the ghostly arm reaching out of the flowers to greet you. The appearance of years of aging and decay are evident in the remains of the drapery, blowing woefully from the cold draft of a broken window. Years of dust and cobwebs collect on once crisp white sheets used to protect the furnishings. Bats seeking refuge from the cold find nesting spots above us, and some have taken flight. Notice, too, the tree of the dead as a warning placed right in the middle of the table. If we dare to get close to inspect the odd-shaped baubles hanging helplessly from its craggy branches, we find the shrunken, shriveled faces of those who've come before us. Then, not from the physical cold, but from sheer terror, an unwieldy shiver runs down our spine. Now that's a Halloween parlor of horror if I've ever seen one. And most of what you see is very easy to create. The aged and tattered draperies hinged with a simple tea stain, and then the ends were ripped and torn to look quite old. Please note that all the candles are positioned far away from any blowing draperies, and they all sit on tinfoil disguised with black stones and gravel. Of course, they should never be left unattended. And in a haunted house, that's never a problem.
There's something about the scraggy, barren branches of an old dead tree that sends chills up your spine. Then when the rich brown bark has turned mysteriously black, and what fruits there are the shrunken, shriveled heads of poor Halloween souls. Well then, you got the perfect Halloween accessory. Follow me over to the haunted shop and we'll do a ghoul box project, if you dare. Your first decision when making a bony skeleton-like Halloween tree is how big to make it. We determined that placing it on the large coffee table in the parlor would create an eerie focal point for the room so the walls could just fall off into the background. So in keeping with the size of the table, we made ours about 24 inches tall and 21 inches wide. Once you know how much material you will need, grab two pieces of half-inch pressed fiberboard. Next, draw a tree on the board using a felt-tip marker. Just make sure to draw the trunk of the tree wide enough to handle cutting a half inch by 8 inch slot in the bottom of one of the trees and a half inch by 8 inch slot in the top of the trunk of the second tree. The two slots allow the two pieces to slide together. Now once your tree is drawn, cut out the spindly shape using a spiral saw. This is an easy way to make tight corners and curves needed for a tree of this design. Also, make sure to cut out the slot in the base of the trunk using a jigsaw. The slot should go exactly halfway up the tree trunk. Then, once the first tree is cut out, trace around it on the remaining board and cut it out. Only this time, put the slot at the top of the trunk, reaching halfway down the tree. Now you want to test fit the two trees. Pull the top tree down through the center, and when the top tree touches the table surface, the tree should stand on its own and be quite sturdy. Now, if the fit is off at all, just make any adjustments and then lightly sand the edges to remove any rough spots. To finish the tree, paint it all black like we did, or design a ghoulish color scheme of your own. Once the tree is dry, it's time to add the shriveled apple faces. These, of course, are peeled apples, carved with faces and then left to age and shrivel up for several days. Now by tying strings or fishing line to the stems, the apples can be hung from the tree to create the most frightening focal point ever.
These moth-eaten, tattered draperies aren't necessarily terrifying to view, but they certainly add to the Halloween fun for an unsuspecting visitor upon entering the spooky parlor. The crisp autumn air sweeping past the fabric remains make these otherwise benign windows a tremendous addition to the mounting fright. Although they appear to have been created over decades of neglect, grotesque fabrications such as these can be conjured up almost like magic. Why don't you join me over in my All Hallows Eve workroom and I'll demonstrate. Spooky, stained, and shredded drapes are actually a bit trickier to make than good old normal draperies because you have to get past the uneasy feeling of ripping up and destroying perfectly good fabric. But it's fun in a mischievous sort of way. First, gather up yards of inexpensive lightweight gauze. Then, cut double the length of your panels from the floor up and over your rods and back to the floor again. If they're a bit longer, all the better. And remember, we aren't sewing side seams or even a hem. We'll just pretend that the hem rotted off years ago. Now, the rods in the room we're working on did not span the length of the sliding glass door, so to extend the rod, I just laid a 1x2 from one existing bracket to the other, just like I have here on my demonstration wall. Once the panels are cut, we have to make them look like they've been hanging around for decades, just like these. So here in the workroom, I can age them by laying the panels on a tarp and spraying them using a spray bottle filled with very strong hot coffee. Now remember to be careful because the coffee is hot, and on a nice day, you may want to spray the panels outside. Once they are dry, bring them in and hang them over your rods, then alter the hemline. Now, I especially enjoy slicing chunks out of the bottom and the side edges. Once you have the outer edges of the drape looking dilapidated, grab folds of the fabric and snip on an angle down towards the floor. This creates chunks of fabric that appear ripped and mangled, and they add to the macabre effect. Now, repeat this all over the drape until you're satisfied with its state of disintegration. All that's left is to enjoy the effect, because they're sure to be so frightening. Up next, make sure you've eaten before you enter this dining room. The appetizers keep crawling off the plates.